हेलो,
आई थिंक हिज
क्या
इंटरनेट
हुआ?
फ्रोज। इसका इंटरनेट फ्रीज हो गया।
हाँ, वही लग रहा है।
डू यू बिलीव इन सुपरस्टिशंस? लाइक सम थिंग्स आर लकी और अनलकी फॉर यू? वेल, द बैड लक फॉर पुअर इंटरनेट इज प्रोबेबली दिस गाय।
वेलकम बैक टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ हेड्स अप विद गोइंदी विद टू वेरी क्लोज फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन, पावन बंसल एंड गौरव सूद, माय फेलो टीममेट्स इन पंजाब डफर्स एंड टू पोकर प्लेयर्स फ्रॉम मीरा। What we're going to do is we're going to have a Punjab Duffers episode. Firstly, sorry to every other teammate of mine. It had nothing to do with you not coming here, but it was just that these two boys are from Meerut and I've never had friends from Meerut.
Meerut. वहाँ आदमी ज़्यादा खबर आती है।
I'm talking to two guys who have total caches of over 10 crores. Okay, you know what that means. Gaurav inching in close to 4 crores in online caches and Pavan Bansal, obviously, if you do the math, it's more than 6 crores, both online and live.
And we have Mr. Goindi here, who has made several crores himself, but he never talks about those.
So, three of us were in the same team in the Poker Sports League. Let me tell you something about Pavan. He played for the Haryana team first year, and they were relegated, and they don't exist anymore. He played for Punjab Bluffers the next year. We ended up at the bottom of the table and we were relegated and we don't exist anymore. I was really, really scared to bring him on the show because the show might get relegated and we might not exist anymore. We entered the PSL with a pretty strong team. We fancied ourselves as the top three team. I'm pretty sure we fancied ourselves. At least I did.
We were definitely in the top three. But I think something went wrong. Maybe getting Sophia was more of a distraction, as you realized.
Yeah, for sure. Pavan mein akele to thi.
And the previous year, we had done pretty well. We were top of the table for most part and we ended up in the money. We came fourth. And this year, I was like, man, I want to get my hands on that trophy. We were staying in this swanky pad. You know, it had like a pool. It had like a pool table. It had like massive rooms. And it was like a luxury. It kind of felt like straight out of a movie. We have a very interesting journey. I met Pavan in 2010 in Goa during one of the IPC tournaments, which he ended up winning.
I'm Pavan Bansal. I got from Meerut. I'm Abhishek Singh Burney. All the way from Bangalore.
And we became really close friends and I learned a lot from him. I realized how big a fish I was. I remember I had this distinct memory. Do you remember we stayed at the Crown Plaza Casino? The Crown Casino in
I remember.
In Goa. And I remember we were playing on stars that time. I was in the middle of a hand and we were discussing the hand and I was like, but what if he's bluffing? And you broke it down and said, but he can't have this. And I just thought to myself, I'm like, damn, I've been winning so many titles and I have no idea how to play poker. And that's when I looked up and I was like, okay, this is the dude I have to learn from. One of my first memories of Gaurav was in PSL where he came in and I remember him telling me, he was like, mujhe sikko banna hai. Mujhe crusher banna hai. I was like, theek hai, ban jayega, kya problem hai, sabko banna hai. And I know a lot of people that have come up to me and have said that. And I remember telling him what the process was to becoming a sikko. Yeah, study, train, you know, play, get your hands reviewed, just put in the volume and just keep getting better and you'll be there. And I think he's done exactly that. Sometimes I'm like, shit. Like, I wish I put in as much effort as he did to become that good that quickly.
Bhaiya bhaiya bol ke
sabki gaan maar di. He picks the strengths of everybody and then he's just built his own foundation.
Pretty much.
When he says, bhaiya, don't fall for that innocent face. Okay, Pawan, if not poker, what would you do in life?
Probably a trader.
Would you rather have $10 million or 10 gold bracelets?
If I get 10 gold bracelets, that means I'm doing well financially. So 10 gold bracelets.
What if you get 10 gold bracelets and up top is $50,000?
For each tournament? Or yeah. 500K is not bad. I still take the bracelets.
Okay. Sofia Lovren or Kate Hall?
Sofia Lovren.
Federer or Nadal?
That's a tough one. But I have to say Nadal.
Okay.
Nadal?
Yeah.
If not a poker player, what would you be?
I'll try to be a writer.
Oh, I thought you would say like tennis player.
No.
You don't like tennis as much?
No, like I like writing more.
One poker dream or goal that you have?
This is a cliche, but winning the World Series, man.
Okay, favorite poker player?
These days is Linus Lolliver.
Okay, favorite poker player in Miramar?
I don't know who all decides there.
It's only me. Okay, Shakespeare. One poker dream / goal.
Playing the highest level of tournaments that are there like, in the world.
If you had to give your stack to one player for your life, who would it be?
Pavan Bansal.
If you had to give your stack to one player for your life, who would it be?
If he's properly awake, then Gaurav Sood, yeah.
Any superstitions that you have in poker?
My uncle, he's an astrologer. He told me if I wear blue, it'll bring me luck. So during the World Series, when I ran deep, all of the 5 days that I was there, I wore the same blue hoodie.
Wow. So clearly poker is not a game of skill. It's the astrologer. Ask him what color I should wear, bro. Definitely.
I think red
should not be wearing red because we lost everything.
There's a silver locket as well, by the way.
Ask your guy about me, man.
I think you'll get described the same thing that I did. Neelam. It's supposed to calm you down.
Okay, I'm gonna get Neelam. Okay, burn, save, marry. Sophia Loren, Maria Ho, or Liv Bohri?
Sophia is just like the girl you can make your mom. So I guess marry Sophia. Love Liv Bohri. Sorry, yeah. Maria.
Federer or Nadal?
Federer.
Burn, save, marry. Maria Ho, Sophia Loren, Liv Bohri.
Yeah, marry Sophia, save Liv Bohri, and burn Maria Ho.
No wonder we never won. Both of y'all were just so into Sophia during the... No wonder. It explains it. It's not y'all. Talking about PSL, which season did you prefer? Season 1 or Season 2?
Season 1, I guess, yeah.
Season 1, I guess. Yeah, same. Because Season 2, we had Pawan Bhaiya on our team. Man, I have so many memories from PSL Season 2. We had the finals the next day. And in my head, I'm thinking, Pawan is our best player. We got to get him to go out there and make us win. And so you can choose 3 people to play the finals, right? By default, the captain had to play. So I was in by default. So now I had to pick between Pawan Bansal, Sophia Loren, and Rajneesh. Rajneesh is baller in his own way, right? And Sophia is Sophia, and Pawan's Pawan. And I was put to a spot, I was put to a test, and I asked everybody. I spoke to Sapra, I spoke to Gaurav, I spoke to everybody. And my gut was telling me to go with Pawan and Rajneesh because Pawan is like solid and he got us points as well. And Rajneesh is the kind of guy who can turn things around on a given day. Right, he's just one of those that can win you matches. He's really good and very exploitative, and he knows how to win games. And Sophia, obviously, is Sophia, and she knows how to play. She plays at the highest level. So I'm debating this, and I'm like, man, if I put in Sophia, she doesn't know everybody else. And Pawan has a better read of players, and Rajneesh has a better read of players. When I'm trying to make this decision, I was supposed to send in the entries. And I'm speaking to Pawan, and Pawan volunteers to sit out from the finals. He volunteers to sit out from the finals, and he's like, I think you should send Sophia in. And I'm like, now I'm thinking to myself, I wish you were still in the Haryana Hunters. Another story for Pawan and me, there was this one chick who was a reporter who came in to report hands during one of the events. Right? And Pawan and I were so close that we would discuss pretty much everything. Pawan and I, both of us look at the girl at the same time and both of us like, yeah, damn, she's good. You know, and Pawan looks at me like with this eagerness and he's like, man, I think I want to go for it. And I was like, I think I want to go for it.
Hum pyar karte hain aapse.
Dono.
Ji.
And he was like, I think I like her. I said, fine, I'll take one for the team. You go for it. Next thing I know, the man is in a 3-year relationship with this girl. And the next thing I know, it's taken him 8 years to do his college. And he blames it on poker. So we leave it at that. We don't know what the true story is.
Who was your favorite player from Punjab Bluffers, both seasons combined?
Both seasons combined? Akira, clutch hero.
Ah, that's a good
clutch
one.
Clutch hero for sure, hands down. Man, that dude was legendary, bro. And
so you have to put them in pecking order as to how close you are to them. Romit, Archit, and Chigi.
I would say Archit, Chigi, and then Romit.
Raghav Bansal, Dhaval Mudgal, or Kunal Patni?
In terms of game?
Yeah.
In terms of game, Raghav Bansal number one, Dhaval number two, Kunal number three.
And in terms of people who you're close to?
Fuck, that's a tough one. I think Dhaval, then it would be Raghav Bansal and I have run a lot closer. Yeah, and then Kunal Patni. I know you have a thing with the Bansals, okay? It's just, if my name was a Bansal, you'd have probably married me. I know you like Pawan Bansal, Raghav Bansal, Kanishk Bansal. Choose one.
Pawan Bansal.
Rate in order of preference.
Pawan Bansal, Kanish Bansal, and then Raghav Bansal. It seems so unfair, like, to put up these options. Yeah.
That was the idea about it, dude.
Yeah. I know.
What is poker to you in one word?
Passion.
Pawan, what is poker to you in one word?
I think determination.
Wow.
I face this question a lot. So this friend of mine who's like playing poker for a long time now, he plays PLO cash and... Like, he dabbles with tournaments because he thinks he lottery lag jayega. He's like, you were 2 of 67 in elite. क्या हुआ? मैंने कहा ब्रो क्या हुआ, तो मैं कहा क्या होता है? He like, तू 2 of 67 था elite में, what happened? मैंने कहा ब्रो tournament poker happened. I have like 50 big blinds. That's like 2 flips. Ace king to jacks, jacks to ace king, खत्म, निकलो यहाँ से.
Yeah.
So like that's what I tell him. Like he's like 2 of 67 था क्या हुआ? It's not a given if you're 2 of 67, you'll get to the final table or something like that, bro. Like
tournament poker is basically wherein you can be 1 of 60 and finish 16th. It's not like a running race where you're 1 of 60 and you'll end up in the top 3 or top 4 because you have a lead. Who according to you is going to win the next bracelet from India? Pavan.
I think I would have to say Gaurav, yeah. If he can make the trip, because I keep telling him every year to come to Vegas and he's like, Are we bankrolling? But now I'm pretty sure he has the bankroll.
Gaurav, who according to you is going to win the next gold bracelet?
I think he's been due a lot. And like he's definitely the best player in India in my eyes, Aditya Agarwal. I think like deservedly it should be him.
Yeah, I mean he's an obvious bet. The odds are always in his favor to win that.
I don't think anyone even comes close.
Yeah, for sure. That is Gaurav Sood and Pavan Bansal, my fellow teammates from Punjab Bluffers. Over 10 crores in total cashes. It's only the beginning. You can expect way more and a lot more international titles. Stay tuned for more such content because poker is not gambling. If you guys want to learn more about poker, subscribe to Poker Bootcamp India. Like, share, and subscribe to AS Goindi on Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook for more such content.